Good morning, class 4. I am Anil Bhagat, your science teacher from Modern International School, Hisar. Welcome back to our e-learning program. Today, in this video lecture, we will discuss about chapter 11, that is the Earth and its neighbors. So today, we are going to start this chapter and we'll discuss the different topics from this chapter one by one. So first of all, we have to understand a little about our solar system. In our solar system, there is a star called Sun, and there are 8 planets, and one of the planets is our planet, that is Earth. And on this planet, we are living, or we are the inhabitants of this planet. And this all planets are revolving around the Sun or orbiting around the Sun. But our planet Earth is different from the other planet as it has life. We are living organism and we are living on this planet, and it has many heavenly names, means very big bodies are there. These are called heavenly bodies, like planets are there, meteorites are there, stars are there, moon is there. So in this chapter we will discuss one by one. So first of all, we will discuss about the Sun. So as I told you, Sun lies in the center of the solar system, in the center of our solar system. And what? It is very big. The size of the Sun is very big. And it is a star. Sun is a star. It has its own light. So Sun is a hot ball of gases. Means gases are there and they react with each other and produce huge amount of energy. So Sun is a hot ball of gases. And as you see, in the sky, in the morning time till the evening, there is a big bright ball, very large ball, because it is a star and it is the closest star to our Earth. Okay class, Sun is the closest star or nearest star to our Earth. But if you come to know about the distance between Earth and Sun, that is 150 million kilometers. The distance between Earth and Sun is 150 million kilometers, and we are calling it the nearest star to our Earth. So see, the other stars are too much far away from our Earth. So that is why we are not able to see the stars properly. These stars are twinkling, or it seems very small in the sky. Now let's discuss a little about Sun. Sun is a ball or a sphere of hot glowing Sun. It is a hot, very hot. The temperature of the surface of the Sun, the temperature of the surface of the Sun is 6000 degree centigrade. The temperature of the surface of the Sun is 6000 degree centigrade. So you can understand how much heat it is. And if you start thinking about the temperature of the center of the Sun, it is very much hot, or it is huge. Means the temperature of the center of the Sun is very high. Okay, next. So Sun provides us both heat and light, and it is the ultimate source of energy for us, or for all the life which is on the planet Earth. And without the Sun, there is no life on the Earth. Because in the previous chapters, we understood about the process of photosynthesis, that plants prepare their food by the help of the light of the sun or energy of the sun. And because of this energy, plants are able to prepare their food. And this food directly or indirectly used by us or all living organisms. So class, thank you for this listening to this video. Be safe at home and thank you.